This form of tactic aims at controlling specific areas of the map. In order to do so, the player needs to learn a few things about the current map they're playing on. I'll try to list whatever I can on what makes a good conservative player. The player needs to know what to expect from the spawn system. They do not necessarily have to fully understand the spawn system, but they do have to be able to intuitively figure out when the spawns have switched. This is to avoid undesirable situations where they are rushed by multiple people at once. This is also to better control the area of the map that they are trying to control. The player needs to know where confrontations occur. They need to know where on the map has the highest traffic. Placing yourself within the part of the map with the highest traffic is not smart. You want at most medium traffic. This also touches on map routes. You have to know where people travel through the most. By denying them access to these routes, you get closer to complete area control. Routes with a lot of traffic can be figured out by observing the hotspots on the map and analyzing the closest path that leads to that area. As should be obvious, being one step ahead of the enemy leads to winning a gunfight. Gaining the upper hand can be as simple as using your teammates to your advantage. For example, if your ally went around the corner and died by a gunshot, you know then that someone is watching that corner or might be coming from that corner. If they weren't using a silencer when they shot your ally, you can pull up the escape menu and check out the minimap to see the distance from your location. Knowing where the enemy is before they figure out where you are is key. Therefore, killstreaks like UAV are almost mandatory. Because of that, you can be pretty certain the enemy will be packing UAV too. Therefore, a perk that covers you from sensors is almost mandatory too. One of the goals to conservative gameplay is to keep your distance. The best weapons to keep your distance are assault rifles and light machine guns. Make sure you use perks that help out your form of gameplay. Sleight of hand, hardened, and ghost are good perks to choose. Useful equipment is mostly the motion sensor, but claymores work fine too. If you want to go completely silent, then a silenced weapon is required. They don't know where you are, but you know where they are. That is the perfect situation to be in. Not all maps allow for conservative gameplay. You should therefore prepare a class made for close combat. I recommend an SMG. I do not recommend shotguns because shotguns imply a form of conservative gameplay that I do not seek to cover here. Shotguns are on their own level that have to know how to get around. The gameplay I am explaining here deals with mostly staying in one area. The only reason to move from that area would be if it is getting too hot to handle or too cold to bear. That is, not enough traffic. When it's too hot to handle though, make sure you have a safe escape route. In Black Ops, Theater Mode has a feature that informs you of all the hotspots. The red spots are where the enemy died, and the yellow spots are where you died. You can view this information by highlighting the recorded match and wait for it to load. This is an excellent way to learn traffic spots and routes. Of course, you have to try out all the spots till you find the best areas to hold down. If you found one but start on the opposite side of the map, you can try to push towards that area until you've secured it or try another good area. When going for the kill, it may be best to try not to take every kill. Don't try to shoot targets too far away that can easily escape you. When you're trying to hold down an area, you'll most likely be in an enclosed area. Therefore, you should try to also conserve your ammo. For a secondary weapon, you should consider a pistol. For secondary weapon attachment, I'd recommend improved iron sights or a faster reloading attachment. You may not be able to win a game like this, but if done correctly, you should end up with a very high kill-death ratio.
Heads up, enemy RCXD. Friendly care package on the way.